Sir, yeah, please congratulate you personally, but it's an honor and pleasure for me to present this talk here. Among his not pupil maybe, but people who collaborate with him, like Vladislav Zhigomirov, and other people who knew him quite well in the 50s, 60s. So I'll speak about, here it was mentioned about the financial crisis, which is quite well known in physics of world energy physics, and has a lot of applications. But today we'll speak about another known proposal of Miranchuk, which was done in 58, it's so-called Miranchuk instabilities. We are known in nuclear physics, I'm not a specialist in nuclear physics, but in solid state physics, we attract a lot of attention quite recently. What is it? So actually I will speak about two examples. One example about the Pomeranchuk instability in perovskite metal strontium ruthenate, and another about the itinerant ferromagnetism, which was tried to discover by Ketterly group in MIT, but unsuccessful. So these are two types of Pomeranchuk instability. So let me remind first what is it. So right after of creation of Landau Fermilikus theory, Pomeranchuk proposed some sort of observation, if you like. So the cornerstone of Landau theory of Fermilikus, that the energy of Fermi system is a functional of a distribution function. So this is this function M sigma is a distribution function, and in ground state, for instance, in liquid helium free, it's just a spherical distribution of Fermi particles with all the states occupied below Fermi status. But the same is true when we have a non-equilibrium situation. So we have deviations from such a spherical distribution. And this is a function of interaction between Fermi particles. So and if we have delta n, an actual distribution function is not a spherical. So just a picture from the original Pomeranchuk particle. In this case, one can substitute this expression, deviation of a real deviation of a real distribution function from equilibrium, and obtain just a function of deviation of energies of initial distribution. So the obvious condition of stability of such deviation is as follows. If you have some arbitrary deviation, in this case, in distribution function, the energy, the deviation in energy should be positive. So the Pomeranchuk simply just take this deviation of Fermi momentum, decompose in spherical harmonics, and decompose the interaction function in Meissner polynomials, substitute it in this expression, and obtain that this deviation of energy is positive, then the combination, the following combination of function of interaction, 1 plus Fn, Fn is just the coefficient of decomposition of interaction function between Fermi quasi particles, is as follows. So, and for a spin part, you see here there is a spin-independent pattern interaction, and this is spin part. So there are two inequalities. So it should be that 1 plus Fn should be larger than 0, and 1 plus Gn, which coefficient? larger than zero. So there are three examples well known from vibration of Landau thermoelectric theory. Landau himself calculated the compressibility of Fermi liquids and found that compressibility in Fermi gases looks like as follows, but in Fermi liquid is 1 plus F0, and certainly compressibility should be positive, and this is the first, if you like, first Pemranchuk inequality. So the second example is a renormalization of mass, effective mass in any Fermi liquid is the M bar mass of electron or helium free atom times 1 plus F1. So it also should be positive. This is a condition of positiveness of effective mass. And the third non-trivial example derived by Landau himself is renormalization of paramagnetic susceptibility, Pauli susceptibility. In denominator we have this 1 plus 3 zero from here. And paramagnetic susceptibility should be positive, but otherwise, if the denominator starts to be negative and somewhere has zero value, you have instability to the ferromagnetic state. So I will finish my talk with this example. The people started to search this violation of these conditions. So what is important now? You see this F and J, they are not just interaction between quasi-particles. They are interaction between quasi-particles times the density of states. So the density of states in three-dimensional Fermi liquid
So any saddle point to any saddle point
divergence in density of states. This is density of states. This is the energy. So this fact we can use in simple model of 2 degrees, like this, energy, it's the kinetic energy as usual. This is a combination of operators of creation and annihilation, and interaction between them is a Landau function, but now we should decompose this Landau function not over the Legendre polynomials, but over the basis functions of reduced representation. In given case, if we discuss the square lattice, over the functions of reducible representations of tetragonal groups. So, and for concreteness, let's discuss P1G representation. In this case, FKK prime is just a product of this cosine, very periodic, and have a symmetry, but the symmetry of this function not at all tetragonal, it's orthorhombic. So, due to this orthorhombic symmetry of interaction, we have a tendency to phase transition of a crystal from the tetragonal phase to orthorhombic phase. So, actually, order parameter for this transition looks like as follows. You see this quite similar to superconductivity, for instance, but in superconducting case, instead of this average of distribution function of electrons, it's just average of it's just a work of anomalous function here, or in case of charge density wave, it's ordering like this. But in the case of a D wave electron pneumatic ordinate, it's just you should average a distribution function of electrons. One can say this is an electron pneumatic ordering, it's a charge density wave if Q vector equal to zero. So now let's just do some trivial calculation. So let's decompose this initial Hamiltonian in respect of deviations of real distribution function of electrons from the average. So, and taking into account this definition of order parameter. So let's substitute this value, neglect the quadratic fluctuations, and in this case we obtain the following mean field Hamiltonian. It's exactly the same procedure as in BCS theory, but unlike BCS theory, it's much more simpler, because here you don't need to reanalyze this this quadratic path of excitations, and new energy of excitations just have the initial form plus this product. This product due to appearance or possible appearance of ordering in this system. So now let's just substitute these excitations in the expression for the canonical potential and minimize this potential in respect of order parameter. You obtain the self-consistency equation just this one, but written exactly now. So, and after you can decompose this in respect of other parameters, of course you obtain the Landau decomposition, nothing else, typical decomposition, known from Landau theory of second order phase transition, with coefficients alpha and beta. Of course alpha somewhere at some value of magnetic field, this is magnetic field here, at some value of magnetic field, and temperature change the sign, and due to this we have an ordered phase. It is also a function of a temperature and magnetic field, and as we see, we have sometimes the second order type transition, sometimes first order type transition, and between them so-called critical point where both of coefficients alpha and beta equal to zero. Of course, all calculations calculations of alpha and beta can be done numerically because you see this this is a real function, so you just substitute numbers for this spectrum, and this spectrum corresponds to Markov singularities at point 0 pi and pi 0. So if the from the beginning one can say that if the Fermi energy near the Markov singularity, you can expect transition from the tetrachronal distribution of electrons inside of a brillion zone to the orthorhombic distribution. So let's see the numerical results. So the picture, first of all, about phase transition. H, I remind you, is magnetic field. T is the temperature. This is a line of a second order type transition. And now what's beta coefficient? Positive alpha coefficient. Change the sign across this line as a function of temperature at any value of magnetic field. Now, at any value in this interval, of course. This is a first order type transition lines with three critical points. So, why is interval, not the region, but interval of fields? Because, first of all, starts to be closer to Markov singularity when we near the Markov singularity, when we go away from Markov singularity, and due to this reason, the shape of this phase diagram looks like as follows. So let's look on the distribution function with order parameter here. It's an amplitude of orthorhombicity, if you like. So this between this in this interval of fields, it's just because it's a first order type transition, it's a jumps. So the value of eta like this, but one can draw also the dependence of eta to upspin and downspin. So they have the following form. So a change of the Fermi surface looks like as follows. Before the phase transition, it has a tetrahedral symmetry. After phase transition, this Fermi surface has a orthorhombic symmetry and starts to be open. But for a spin up component, it's open, and for a spin down component, it's orthorhombic as well, but closed. So the dependence of number of electrons with spin up looks like as follows. There are jumps here, like this, and the jumps for n down, spin down, like that. And it's interesting that then the interaction in this B, G1 channel is absent in this case. There is a dependence of magnetic field, but there is no phase transition. These phase transitions, known in solid state physics as a metamagnetic transition, it's not a ferromagnetism, it's just a jump in magnetization induced by external magnetic field. It's not a spontaneous phase transition as usual in ferromagnetism. So magnetic point behaves like this. So without interaction, it's just proportional to magnetic field. It's a powerless susceptibility and nothing else. But in presence of this premiumatic instability, there are two jumps like this and return back to the previous behavior outside of this region of phase diagram. Now, let me say what is the relationship of all of these observations, very simple theoretical observations, to the experiment. Strontium ruthenate, it's a tetrachronal material like this. Of course, it's multi-band material, and this picture with one band is oversimplification of real life. Anyway, phase diagram looks like as follows. Here, field, you see it's at magnetic field of order of 785 Tesla or something like that, there is a metamagnetic transition up to this field, roughly speaking, experimentalists they claim that this is the first order type transition or metamagnetic transition. Here also a first order type transition. Here there is a second order type transition. Now the different color points correspond to measurements of magnetization, magnet restriction, resistivity, and so on and so forth. So you see the data behave consistently. Now, several words about resistance. So if we apply magnetic field along C direction in this crystal, so exactly at this field, there is a jump in resistivity measured along the A direction. So you see this tetrahedral crystal, so the current flow in Basel plane, the magnetic field applied by me. So there is a jump, then after some field interval, there is a back jump. And the value of resistance starts to be a little bit different, but so like this. It was proven that in all three phases, if you like, it's a good metal. So it was measured by Dehaas-Van-Alten effect. So Dehaas-Van-Alten effect exists here, here, and inside. And so no doubt about the metallic nature of this transition. But the crucial observation was as follows. If we start, as I said, here magnetic field parallel to C direction, if we start to a little bit incline this magnetic field from the C direction in A direction, so actually it was done tilt to the angle 77 degrees. 77 degrees is the angle between magnetic field and A axis. And still measure the current along A and B directions. So here you see a complete isotropy, as it should be in tetrahedral field. But if we incline a magnetic field, there is a big difference for an inclination, for a current along A axis and for a current in perpendicular direction. It means that in initial picture, when I explain this Pomeranchuk type phase transition, there are two types of, if you like, Pomeranchuk domains, because with spontaneous breaking of tetrahedral symmetry can be in x direction and in y direction. There are two types of domains, and in average, this crystal still still tetrahedral. But when we apply magnetic field, the symmetry between x and y direction is broken. And here the authors show the difference, the dependence of difference between the resistance in A and B direction for an inclined field. As a spot. So they propose to say about this behavior as about behavior order parameter inside of this this value of course proportional to order parameter in this for this transition.
Володя, it seems there is a negative slope at this phase diagram.
Yes, but life is more complicated. So you see, negative slope, actually, people discuss this, and there is another Pomeranchuk effect here, because the corresponding derivative for not dp over dt, but dh over db has a wrong sign here, actually. So, but it's different questions. It's many bound material and so on. But qualitative level looks like it's similar to propose. Maybe naive explanation. So let me conclude about this first part. So Van't-Hoff singularity near thermal level is favorable situation for the Pomeranchuk instability. For a Fermi surface, in other words, for a Fermi surface distortion. It's not a due to interaction between the atoms, but this is a pure electronic phase transition. It's an important fact. And the real real anisotropy is due to the orthorhombic symmetry of distribution of electrons. So one can say about this ordering as about formation electron pneumatic structure.
So how many time I No, but you have some time. How much you need?
Well, that's several slides first.
Because it's kind of the conclusion that...
No, it's conclusion for the first part. So the second, so is this part, if you like, is successive in some sense, because on qualitative level it's okay. But the research for ferromagnetism, in other words, for Pomeranchuk instability with negative value of G, zero, the story finished in negative sense. And so I'll just say about
what
this.
You have time, but how much?
What? 10 minutes.
Yes.
So let me say that. Let me remind you that susceptibility G power is 1 plus G0. And if 1 plus G0 equal to 0, we have instability to ferromagnetic state. So what is going on in helium? In helium, G0 at normal pressure, it's about minus 2 Kelvin. Helium free exists up to 34 atmosphere in liquid state, and then starts to be solid. At 34 atmosphere, it's at minus 3.4. A little bit smaller, but not still in not enough to have this phase transition.
In what case, again,
it's pressure equals to zero, ambient pressure, 34 atmosphere. Oh, phase diagram, I
format. For what substance?
Helium-free.
Huh?
For helium-free. Because helium-free is only classic term.
It's okay. No,
so, and what was people searching for? Oh, sorry. So, VS was searching for a Pomeranchuk instability with G0 smaller than minus 1. You see, it's the smallest value in helium free is minus 3.4. So, and this attempt was done by a group, the same group who discovered a couple of years ago the Bose condensation in fault atoms, leader of this group, Wolfgang Ketterle in MIT. So in this case, we worked with lithium-6 atoms. And lithium, as you know, has a structure of hydrogen.
What region? When there is negative A or positive A?
A.
Because for lithium-6 atoms, yes? What you are discussing just now, in superfluid part, or
I will speak about.
Yeah, because it's.
It depends. Yes, yes, yes.
Yes.
Now I just discuss this situation and some abstract formulation. If you have some particles with just Hamiltonian of these Fermi particles. It's kinetic energy of spin up particles and kinetic energy of spin down particles. And on model level, one can discuss them as in Landau Fermi-Leavitt theory, repulsion between the particles with opposite spin. Point like repulsion. Point like repulsion. For a model. What we can expect inside of this model? still it's interesting. People calculate with model with increasing accuracy, if you like. So what are results? So this potential between of interaction between the atoms with opposite spin. So it's a pseudo function array, it's a so-called pseudo potential. And in first order of this A is the scattered energy. So in first order, it's easy, it's any person here can calculate himself. So there is a kinetic energy consistent, as I said, for spin up particles. Eta here is the difference between number of spin up and spin down particles. So this is a kinetic energy for spin up particles, this is a kinetic energy for spin down particles, and this is interaction. Interaction, of course, is product of a number of spin up and spin down particles. So one can decompose this expression in respect of eta. First of all, it was done half a century ago by Young. He found, and you can repeat this, it's quite easy calculation, that this energy at zero temperature, of course, looks like as follows. There is a decomposition, Landau decomposition in respect of this other parameter. So this quadratic term with quartic term. And this term changes sign when product of K Fermi to scattering length is larger than 2 pi, pi over 2. It means that the interaction between the particles should be quite strong because it should be of the order of pi over 2. So, but this result only in the first order of perturbation theory. When quite recently people calculate the second order and so on and so forth. What, and moreover calculated more or less exactly with application of quantum Monte Carlo technique. And they found that still we have second order type transition to polarized ferromagnetic state, then K Fermi A larger than not pi over 2, like in first order type theory, but larger than 0.82. So, как можно
прекратить? Привет, Сейман.
А я тут. Хорошая музыка.
But look, in any real system, it's difficult to expect to find with such a strong interaction. It's a quite strong interaction, actually. So, but maybe naive idea of Kepler group to use for these purposes so-called Fersbach resonance. Because near Fersbach resonance, I will explain in a few minutes what is it. There is a divergence in the scattering length, and due to this reason, one can expect to obtain the phase transition to a pure ferromagnetic state in whole gates. So, now what is Fersbach resonance? So, lithium 6 atom has a nuclear spin 1. With electron, it's one electron of S shell, so the sum of this 1 plus minus 1 half, it's just 3 half and 1 half, and corresponding number of projections for all of them, so the total we have a in applying of magnetic field to this system, we have the Zeeman splitting of the levels. So for four levels corresponding to total magnetic to total orbital moment of lithium six atom, three half and another to one half. So, and roughly speaking, you see, because the difference between your nuclear magneton and electron magneton is huge, and due to this reason, here, these levels correspond to electron to spin electron down. This levels correspond to spin electron up. And to each of them, we should just add the value, the value, the different value of a nuclear spin projection. And due to this reason, there is splitting between them in neglect of nuclear magneton. It's just two lines. Here we split in a zero field. It's just due to hyperfine interaction. So some I forgot the number, but so not important for us. So now we see that the spin is conserved quantity. It means that if you have two particles with total spin at infinity equal to something, after collision between them or in the intermediate state, we should have a particle with the same spin. And for computers, if we discuss the collision of two lowest, you see A and B hyperfine states. So the atoms in this state. So of course they are in this state, it's the most energetically profitable. So according to this conservation law, transition to AD states is possible. D has the same spin projection minus two, minus one half as a B state. So this transition is possible, but you see between them great difference, the amount energy difference. What does it mean? It means that if at infinity you have a potential like this, so and it's some level, an energy level like that, then and they have some magnetic energy, but when we go close, the distance between starts to closer and closer, they can scatter each other, changing this state of A atom, B atom to D state. And in this case, the Zeeman energy works, and this level shift to up. And in this case, this energy starts to be almost equal to zero, the energy of bound state. But you know from quantum mechanics that if the energy of bound states close to zero, there is divergence in scattering length. And the actual picture, and this is a phenomenon in nuclear physics known as the Hedgehog resonance. And here you see one can organize this Hedgehog resonance artificially by means of application of magnetic field exactly at equal to difference between the zero and the bound state energy of state in this potential of interaction between two leading atoms. So here the picture of the dependence of scattering length, this is divergence, like this. This is a field corresponding to the Hedgehog resonance. All this line corresponds to attraction. But bound state, as you know, for 3D case, bound states exist only for large enough attraction between the atoms. So the bound state exists till here, but after we still have attraction, but no bound state. And this, in cold atom theory, we call this region as BCS. BCS region because we still have attraction between atoms, but without the formation of bound states in 3D case, and we actually can obtain the phase transition to the superconducting state here, or superfluid state here. This region actually corresponds to Bose-Einstein condensation because here there is bound state. And so we have limit of Strong-Cowbrin theory is the limit of strong attraction between particles and divergence in scattering length. But on the other hand, the positive large value of this entity corresponds to possibility to develop for ferromagnetic stability. So just in language of many body theory, there are two channels. One channel is formation of Bose-Einstein condensate, and another channel the formation of ferromagnetic state. Actually, experiment was organized as follows. They prepare a vacuum atoms here, that small magnetic field, then very fast include magnetic field to a Fishbach resonance. They increase this value A and believe that due to this reason, first of all, instability to ferromagnetic state start to develop much faster than the Bose-Einstein condensation. So this was initial idea of heterodyne. So they even published article that they succeed with this program. I just would say from a theoretical point of view how to discuss this procedure. One need to derive, if you like, Ginzburg-Landau, time-dependent Ginzburg-Landau equation for two channels. One channel for formation of Bose-Einstein condensation, and another channel for formation of ferromagnetic state. Of course, this problem nobody did. But there are some preliminary calculations, and all of them show that Ketterly idea was wrong. Bose-Einstein condensation always faster. Experimentally, we try to do it. And so here, there is a book more or less. Fermi temperature, you see microkelvin. So the number of atoms they have in track about million. So the actual temperature was about 10 times smaller than Fermi temperature. Then they fast increased the magnetic field. And in fact, we found formation of two particle bound states, but not ferromagnetic field. So that we not obtain any big fluctuations of magnetic moment. And no magnetic moment at all. So, but they registered formation at a lot of bound molecules consisting of lithium 6 atoms. So the conclusion of them was pessimistic. So based on our observations, it seems that this phase transition to ferromagnetism, which is known, it's one of Pomeranchuk instabilities, but in solid state physics it's convenient to say about this as about Stoner instability, cannot be realized in nature. So maybe it's wrong, but in this case it's indeed the case. Thank you.
Thank you. Let me tell you, I don't understand, but the most of audience know it. In case of Fishbach resonance, in Ketterly study, they are studying not spin half and spin minus half. They, it's very interesting, they use two fermions, lithium-6, but different hyperfine structure. So you have different particles, fermions. Now they can interact between themselves because it's especially in Fishbach resonance, it's like particles with opposite spin, but it's effectively. Nevertheless, in magnetic field, what is shown here, spin are polarized in one of the same direction. That's why, because it's usually magnetic trap. It's a typical for Hertzberg resonance. Spin parallel, but at the same time, two component you have hyperfine interaction, different hyperfine interaction, and you have interaction between spin. Voltaic spin is the same, but you have at the same time just Hertzberg resonance when from this state of this spin you have formation of intermediate state, resonance state, this formation of quasi-molecules, it's a first, but when you talk about A plus more than zero, in this case there is dimers.
Yes,
there is dimers, live dimers, and that's why it's quite different problems. Because it's already interaction between dimers and the...
After all, but the formation of dimers, it has is deformed already, not a magnetic transition at all.
Again, dimers, again, you are moving by... Because when chemical potential is decreasing, A is more than zero, you have dimers. Dimers is a completely different system. Because it's a quasi-molecule in some extent. So that's why it's very difficult to impose the same question which Pomeranchuk
said. No, idea of if we forget, for instance, about diamonds, it's exactly corresponds to prevention. But actually, the system prefers dimers, and that's all.
When there is A more than zero, always there are dimers. Is A more than zero, always there are dimers. It's a specific, it's just specific Hertzberg resonance. So, no, it's my remark. Please, what are questions?
What about iron or nickel, ferromagnetic metals?
All of them are not the itinium ferromagnets. Actually, they form from interaction between localized moment and itinium subsidy. So, but here there was a pure idea. We have complete itinerance.
Uh-huh.
Let's look what is going on. Still about the iron, not so clear.
Are there additional questions? If not, let's go. Neither asked me to invite you for a workshop.
Right here.
Я думаю, что это не так.